Hi everyone and welcome back. In the last video, we created our own full adder for 4-bits and I left you off with a question which was what would we do if we wanted to convert this to an 8-bit adder, and the answer is just to convert all of these 3s to 7s and I can actually make this an 8-bit adder. So at this point, I think we need a better way to do it, because what if I want to convert my adder easily? And if you've done programming in other languages, you would probably make some kind of a constant, and that's exactly what we're going to be doing with the word parameter. So I just say parameter size equals 4. That's the size of my adder. I'm saying it would be 4 for now, and here as well I'll need to write parameter size equals 4. And what this parameter word does is it creates a constant for me, and let's actually try not giving a value here, and let's make these 3 for now, and let's try this out. As you can see, it says syntax error in parameter list, and that's because for this constant I haven't given any value yet. So let's say I keep this to 4, and now I compile it. As you can see, it compiles fine. So what I'm going to use this size for is to mention here, instead of 3, I'm going to say size minus 1. And here as well, I would do a size minus 1. And the same here as well, I do a size minus 1. And similarly for all of these, I do a size minus 1 and a size minus 1 here. And a size minus 1 here as well. And then I can actually give this an 8-bit value if I change my size to 8. So once I change my size to 8, I can actually give 8 bits input, and I've converted my entire adder to an 8-bit adder. So that's basically what the use of this parameter keyword is. Remember that this is still a constant, so don't think of A to be a variable length register or variable width register. This is still not variable width. This is just some predefined width, which is 4 in this case, and we're just using that same number everywhere. And this is not variable width. This width of my register A still cannot change during runtime. So that's it about the parameter keyword, which I wanted to discuss in this video, and I'll see you next time.